these sinful eyes were blessed with the honor of seeing Shaykhul Hadith Mawlana Zakariyya Saheb rahmatullahi alayhi when he came to bury twice. And I was studying in college at that time, and during my late school days and college days, I used to participate in the tablighi work. And my father was the murid of Shaykhul Hadith Mawlana Zakariyya Saheb rahmatullahi alayhi. So we used to hear a lot about Shaykhul Hadith Mawlana Zakariyya Saheb rahmatullahi alayhi. When we used to go in Jamaat, we used to read Fadail-e-Amal, Fadail-e-Amal, Fadail-e-Amal. It was known as tabligh-inseparable in those days. So when we heard, when I heard that Shaykhul Hadith Mawlana Zakariyya Saheb rahmatullahi alayhi was coming to the UK, I was overjoyed. And I took 1 week off from college. I was only 17 years old. But because of the tarbiyah and the nurturing of my father, I always, right from my childhood, had inclination towards the akabir and the mashayikh and the pious servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whoever they may be. And Shaykhul Hadith rahmatullahi alayhi, I was very much impressed because Fadail-e-Amal was being read all the time in the masjid. It was being read at home by my father. And when we used to go in Jamaat, we used to study Fadail-e-Amal. So Shaykhul Hadith, the author of Fadail-e-Amal, Shaykhul Hadith, the Shaykh of my father, whom my father frequently mentioned, so I should spend as much time as possible in his company. So I went to Darul Bari. And I took a few friends along as well, and I said to them, I said, you know who's coming? The author of Fadail-e-Amal is coming. We should go and spend some time in his company. A very pious personality. Those of you who have seen Shaykhul Hadith rahmatullahi alayhi, in the last stages of his life, he was disabled. So throughout the day, a program was set for 24 hours. And all the people who were coming followed that program. And people were coming in thousands, my friends. Thousands. People were coming in thousands. They were flocking towards Shaykhul Hadith Saheb rahmatullahi alayhi. After Fajr, this amal. After that rest, then breakfast, then ta'aleem. Then bayan of one of his khulafa. After Zohar, this amal. Shaykhul Hadith rahmatullahi alayhi used to come out of his room. He used to perform all his salat in his room because the gathering was so large that the sufuf used to reach where he was in seclusion. And he used to perform salat from his room with jama'ah. Shaykhul Hadith rahmatullahi alayhi used to come out and sit with the public between Asr and Maghrib daily. And the only thing that used to happen is that his grandson, Mawlana Shahid Sahib, used to read something from Fadail-e-Amal or from any book that was instructed by Shaykhul Hadith Mawlana Zakariyya Saheb rahmatullahi alayhi. So Shaykhul Hadith rahmatullahi alayhi used to come out of his room after the Asr Salat, and he used to go back in his room before the Maghrib Salat. Everybody was given the opportunity to sit in his company for 1 hour. And in this 1 hour, thousands of people used to come during the evening. I still remember that picture when daily, after the Asr Salat, people in thousands, their gazes would be towards that door from which Shaykhul Hadith is going to come. So much love people had for that Wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we follow the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in its entirety, if we follow the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in its entirety, then we will become the beloved of Allah. And it is a promise that when one becomes the beloved of Allah, he becomes the beloved of the whole creation. If a person on an individual basis will follow the whole deen of Allah, then Allah will make him the beloved. And if the whole ummah, the ummah as a whole, will follow the whole deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then the ummah as a whole will become the beloved of the people. So I was saying, Shaykhul Hadith rahmatullahi alayhi, daily, I spent 7 to 8 days there, I saw Shaykhul Hadith, I shook his hand, I met him, but daily, there was that eagerness that I want to see his face, I want to see his face. So, after the Asr Salat, all eyes are set towards that door. The door used to open, and my respected teacher, Hadrat Mawlana Yusuf Mutala Sahib, Damat Barakatuhum used to walk out of the door. That used to mean that within seconds, Shaykhul Hadith will appear. And thereafter the wheelchair used to appear. Literally, I'm telling you, my friend, literally. Literally, I'm telling you, without any exaggeration, before the coming of Shaykhul Hadith, rahimahullahu ta'ala, tube lights were there in the big tent. Thousands of people are there, full of light, no darkness. But when Shaykhul Hadith used to enter that tent, when his face used to come inside, there was so much noor in that tent that we used to feel that we were in darkness before Shaykhul Hadith came. And as soon as he used to emerge from that door, Allahu Akbar, as soon as he used to emerge, no bayan, no taqreer, nothing. You would hear, Allahu Akbar, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, zikr from all four directions. I still find the enjoyment of that moment today, my friend. And then Shaykhul Hadith used to come on the stage. He used to take his place. And for 1 hour continuously, he would be in meditation. He would be in meditation for 1 hour continuously without moving. In his old age, when he was paralyzed, two people had to lift him and put him on the stage. Majority of the time, Mawlana Shahid Sahib used to read from the book. Even while the reading of the book is taking place, I was a teenager. I was only 17 years old. So I used to continue to look at Shaykhul Hadith. Sometimes I used to look to the right to see the feeling, sometimes to the left, because I was very young and I could not understand that there is no lecture, there is no bayan. Why do people say Allahu Akbar? Why La ilaha illallah suddenly? Why Subhanallah? Why somebody screaming? Why somebody shedding tears? Why somebody sobbing? I just couldn't understand. So I used to look around me. You would see people crying, people sobbing. Their tears rolling down their cheeks. And you could see that without any bayan from Shaykhul Hadith rahmatullahi alayhi, people are just sitting there and repenting and connecting their hearts with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when sometimes he decided not to have the book reading and he remained quiet, the same thing happened. Whole 1 hour quiet, but people are crying. People are sobbing. Suddenly you would hear somebody say, La ilaha illallah from this side. So Shaykhul Hadith Mawlana Zakariyya Sahib rahmatullahi alayhi, this great personality,